we've inherited an impoverished definition of creativity within our society. London Business School PhD student Jennifer Lynch is a guest speaker for a TED Talk where she discusses the false perceptions people have towards creativity and argues the popular belief
that only those with exceptional artistic talent or uniquely inventive minds can qualify as creative. But creativity isn't what you do, it's how you do it. And we can start to see our interactions with other people, our relationships, as a domain of creativity.
This quote provides the basis of creativity and defines it as the process of changing the domain of a culture with new innovations and symbolic rules. To understand this concept, we must go over the three distinct parts within the systems model of creativity. The domain is a set of rules and practices played within a system. The more mature a domain, the more clear and easy it is to contribute. An example could be a film production, the practices that are executed before, during, or after the shooting of a film. The field represents the experts within the domain that create barriers and determine what contributions may enter the domain. This could be the film director, producer, and so on. The individual is the person who provides new ideas that are judged by the field and may contribute and shape the domain. An example could be the late Oscar-winning special effects artist, Larry Butler, who successfully created the blue screen during the production of the cinematic big-budget movie, Thief of Baghdad, which is widely used in film production today. The consequences of the systems model of creativity are that creativity manifests within domains and may fluctuate, meaning what cultures may have deemed creative long ago may not relate to what they find creative now.